Hello guys, in this video we are going to compare Gboard and SwiftKey. Both are from two popular tech companies. Gboard is from Google while SwiftKey is from Microsoft. Let's see what both can offer. Regarding the languages, both keyboards support over 300 languages. We can change the input type in both the keyboards. Moving on to themes, themes are very important because no one likes the same user interface again and again. Both support themes and come with built-in themes. SwiftKey has over 300 themes which you can download from the store. Gboard comes with a store in which you can change themes, colors and the background image. Both support custom themes and you can add a background image and change the brightness for the image. Regarding themes, both keyboards are equally great. Let's move to the settings. Both support different types of settings from autocorrect to spell check. Both come with settings to customize the keyboard. A good thing about SwiftKey is it saves your data, including efficiency, tabs saved, word predicted, amount, etc. We can resize the keyboard, activate, deactivate keyboard tone and vibration, change voice settings, swipe keyboard settings, etc. You can delete the personal dictionary in dictionary menu in Gboard, while all the data can be found in account menu in SwiftKey. Moving on, let's see both keyboards in action. Both come with a search bar. Gboard displays the results in a small window with an option for gifts. You can copy and paste the information for places, times, etc. SwiftKey shows the entire web page. Users can search for places, copy and paste the information, and browse the internet. Both support GIFs, stickers, emojis and collection. The user interface in both is different. SwiftKey comes with GIFs categorized while you can create own GIFs in Gboard. Alright, next thing, translation. The competition is tough as both support translation. Gboard uses Google Translation service while SwiftKey uses Bing Translation. While translating how are you in Hindi, I could see Gboard gives a professional translation. You can also download Bing Translator for SwiftKey to translate the text in over 60 languages offline. Regarding the features, SwiftKey keyboard is ahead of Gboard. SwiftKey comes with a row where the user can access all the settings instantly. You can share calendar information, location information, access gifts, collection and stickers. You can also change the settings like autocorrect, emoji prediction, floating, layout, keyboard size, etc. A cool feature in SwiftKey is emoji prediction. If enabled while typing, it suggests you the emoji. For example, typing TIOL would suggest the toilet emoji and you can tap that emoji to add to the message. Gboard also comes with features to access settings like themes, translation, etc. but it is limited against SwiftKey. You can add or remove the components from the row in the row settings in SwiftKey. Holding the space bar in Gboard opens the input where you can change the input settings or change the keyboard at all. Moving on, both use Google Voice input, so there is no competition in that. Although language and hardware can affect the voice typing, Google Voice input is very popular and Google uses your spoken data to improve their services. In the test, both keyboards added 2 while in the sentence it was 2. I don't know if it's me or my accent, but make sure you check for any mistakes before sending the message. The last but not least is swiping. Both support swipe typing called flow in SwiftKey and glide in Gboard. With intelligent machine learning and artificial intelligence, both learn from what you type. Before testing the flow typing, I deleted all the learned words from the dictionary in both the keyboards. According to Android Authority, Gboard has overcome SwiftKey regarding auto-correction, flow typing, and words prediction. But everyone has different opinion. While swiping, Gboard could not find word Gboard while it could find SwiftKey. Meanwhile, SwiftKey keyboard could find both the words. SwiftKey also missed the word other while Gboard got the success on that one. For words prediction, we need enough data to prove which one is better, although my post which you can check out in the cards menu and the description which is all about Gboard versus SwiftKey. You can check out for the words prediction and a detailed review of each feature. Anyway, millions of users use one of both keyboards every day, and everyone has different opinion. While regarding tools and features, SwiftKey is still the king. Anyway, that is from me. I hope the video helped. Thanks for watching, and let me know which one do you use and your reviews about the keyboard in the comments below. Until see ya next time.